Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our annual Music Day. March is called Music in Our Schools Month, and we try to do a big annual celebration every year of Music in Our Schools. We're so happy to have you all here tonight, and so delighted to be able to have our special guest, the Trade Academy Band. Very dear to my heart, as I see all of them there. When they were way down here, a little bit crazy, and now look at them, looking great. And the Seacoast Wind Ensemble. Thank you all so much for being here. This is always such a great celebration of music in our schools, and the importance of music in our educational system. And I'm so appreciative of our school administration, our principals, our superintendent, and all of you as taxpayers who support this, which we certainly don't take for granted as well. It's a marvelous time together to share and enjoy, and we hope you enjoy. So we're going to start. We have several groups here. We're going to start with our sixth grade band, way over there in the corner. Alright, we're going to be playing two pieces for you. The first one is called Three Sea Shanties. And the Three Sea Shanties, they're original pieces. The first one is called Ahoy Mateys. The second one, A Sailor's Lament. And the third one is called Land Ho. And if you wouldn't mind, waiting on your applause until after the third shanty, that would be marvelous. So we hope you enjoy our first piece of the evening, Three Sea Shanties. Thank you. Thank you very much. The sixth grade band will play one more piece before we turn it over to our seventh and eighth graders. And this one features our clarinet section. It's called Clarinets on the Run.
That wasn't me.
Thank you for your patience for that. I think that we had a little bit of percussion coming around, and always a little bit of stuff. We got it. So, we're moving on to our 7th and 8th grade band. This is a group I call my COVID survivors. The 8th graders were, we start band 6th and 5th grade generally. And the 8th graders were halfway through 5th grade, so halfway through their first year when everything got shut down. And then we went their entire 6th grade year doing virtual band online when they were from their homes. And then they came back in 7th grade and they were still wearing playing masks for about 6 or 7 months. It's only this last year that it's been somewhat kind of like back to normal. So really, really proud of my 8th graders who stuck it out through all that and made it through. And the 7th graders, like I say, normally start as 5th graders. We didn't get to start until May of their 5th grade year when they got maybe 3 lessons and then it was the summer. So they basically missed their entire first year. So they're only in their 2nd year of playing instead of their 3rd year. And they've also really come a long way and done a tremendous job. So even though I always call it the small but mighty band. And I'm very, very proud of my 7th and 8th graders, what they've been able to accomplish and persevere through. And we hope you enjoy the performance tonight as much as we've enjoyed putting it together. The first piece is called Awaken, and it's by a composer called Kate Nishimura, who's from Canada. And she's written a lot of wonderful music. In fact, our Seacoast Wind Ensemble plays some pieces by her as well. And I just want to read the concert note for her, because it is very appropriate to this whole coming out of COVID season feeling. This is what she writes. Awaken was the first large-scale piece I completed after an almost five-year hiatus. I felt as though it was my own personal moment of awakening after being in a somewhat stagnant state for a long time. I was inspired by the feeling of waking up to a sunny morning, the warmth pouring in the windows, and the feeling of being open to whatever happens in the day. The music represents this optimism and the energy needed to take on whatever the day brings. I feel that Awaken has two sources of inspiration, the literal experience of waking up to a new day and also the reveal of a new sense of self. So we hope you enjoy it as much as we've enjoyed putting it together, Awaken. And I'd also like to thank Dave Blom from the Seacoast Wind Ensemble, who's been helping out our 7th and 8th grade percussion a little bit tonight as well. Thank you, Dave. Our final piece before we turn it over to Trace Academy is called An American March, which is an original tune, but the center part of it is based on America the Beautiful.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Lonnie Westcott. I'm the music teacher at Trade Academy, one man band for chorus and all the other classes. And I'm honored to work with these young people every day. And it sure beats working, I'll tell you. We're going to do two pieces for you. The first one is a piece, it's from a large piece of music. It's actually from a larger piece of music that has six movements. And the large piece of music is called Lincolnshire Posy. Lincolnshire's county in England, and Posy is, of course, a flower. So about 1905, 1906, there was a fellow in Australia who was living here in America. He decided he was going to go to England, to the county of Lincolnshire. And he had a bicycle, and he had a partner with him, and he had one of the new Edison wax cylinder recording machines that he strapped to the back of his bicycle. And he was going to pedal around Lincolnshire and seek out all the songsters, all the storytellers, and record their music to preserve it, because many of these people could not read nor write, and certainly couldn't read or write music. And so if he didn't do this, if someone didn't do it, all that music would be lost when the last person in the room died off. So he did that, pedal around. Wax cylinders are not the most durable media. They're not like compact discs. But somehow he managed to do it, came back to the States, then waited 30 years before he arranged them into this piece called Lincolnshire Posy. He called them each one of his little flowers that he had picked in Lincolnshire. But when he arranged them for concert band, he didn't fix them. So many of these recordings, when he recorded these folks, they were either very old or maybe they had a bit of Irish coffee, who knows? But they weren't exactly perfect in their meter, in their tempo, and there was some give and take. So what Percy Grainger did was he wrote it down exactly as it was they recorded, which really makes for some weird tempo changes and weird time changes, maybe, but it's what gives this piece of music its character and what really endears it to many parts of certain many people in Zico's Wind Ensemble will play Lincolnshire Posy. Yes, they're nodding and smiling. They know. And so we're going to do one piece from that, Horkstown Range, which is a story about two men who were Horkstown Range, a miser and his man, two old men who were infighting their whole lives. And it was never really resolved, as evidenced by the last chord in the piece, which doesn't really seem like it's finished or resolved. So this is Horkstown Range. Thank you. It's great how real good music transcends generations. You know, that was premiered in 1937, and just has remained in the concert band catalog. Even though it's not top 40 music, it's not super engineered by a committee, it's still great music, and you can tell that when you're playing it, you can tell that when you're listening to it. Our next piece, I chose, not really thinking about world politics very much, it's called A Russian Festival. And for obvious reasons, we won't go into those politics, but I will say, the Russians know how to write music. They certainly do. I mean, a lot of their music is minor mode and powerful, and nobody suffers quite like the Russians, I'll tell you. And so this is a piece, it's a medley of pieces, and if you're a Cold War baby like I am, you're going to recognize some of these little tunes as tunes you heard growing up. One of them was the tune on Gilligan's Island whenever a Russian was... That one. So you're going to hear that. It starts off very slow and very draggy. The musical term is passante. And passante means just heavy and slow. And I told the students, think of, you're a Russian peasant and you're trudging home in the slush and there's holes in your boots and there's a candle in the window of your cabin a ways and you're looking forward to a dinner of cold potato soup again. So that's kind of the feel. But it certainly gets brighter from there. So we give you a Russian festival. Thank you for having us, and thank you, Mr. Roth, for all the work he does. I neglected to mention the trumpet solo on that last piece was Riley Netto.
Thank you. strategy with the rest of the set of questions. Thank you. Good evening. Before I say anything else, first another round of applause for all of our incredible musicians today. It's really great to hear the musicians play in the middle school and high school band. It's a lot of fun to hear that and to know that music, not only the future, but the present music. My name is Mark Sipke. I'm the conductor for the Seamless Wind Ensemble, and I still have a chef. I also have to thank you because this is our home on Tuesday nights. We come up here, we're down here from far and wide to the Mercer on Tuesdays. We have a concert coming up in April, and it's all based on dance music, or mostly based on dance music. The first piece we're going to perform today is a piece called Four. I have a very short-term memory problem. This is called Conga de Fuego Nuevo. It's by a Mexican composer by the name of Arturo Marquez. It was arranged by American composer Paul Pickle. It's kind of a catchy little tune. It's got a little slow section in it. I hope you enjoy it. Conga de Fuego Nuevo. Thank you.
Okay, I'm really loud. While he's trying to figure this out, I'm going to invite our assistant conductor up. He's a man we all know, who's been very busy tonight. We are very, very grateful to have him.
We are very grateful to have him as our assistant conductor. He's going to talk a little bit about this piece. And again, I'm serious thanks to John, who allows us and welcomes us to our kitty every Tuesday night when it's not snowing or raining or whatever, to rehearse with you guys. So thank you, John. And
it's always it's so great for me to be able to sit in the back of the, you know, after doing all the conducting that I do with the kids all day, to be able to sit in the back of the band and play my trombone and just and be able to listen and learn from Mark. It's just wonderful. And I've learned so much. And I'm very appreciative of this group, too, for allowing me to be their assistant conductor. I was counting it up the other day. I think this is my 16th year of being their assistant conductor. And it's just such a privilege and an honor to be able to do that. They tolerate me well. They put up with me. And I learned a lot from that every time I get on the podium. So our next piece is called Trish Trash Polka, which translates to Chick Chat Polka, by Johann Strauss, who wrote all those famous waltzes that we all know and love. And so this is a polka, so it's keeping that dance theme. And it's just a little bit of chit-chat back and forth between different sections of the band. So we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
much. And now to wind up this grand affair, we're going to combine forces. So I am going to put my podium right here in the middle, and then everybody kind of turns so you can see me. And we're going to play a Japanese koku called Sport. Well, we're trying to sort out all 21 percussionists. Percussion just kind of moves to the middle. Moves to the middle. Get all together, percussion. While we're doing that, at the end of the concert, if you can please just allow our performers to go out first and put their instruments away. If anyone is available to help grab some chairs or stands, we always appreciate that so much. Again, thank you all so much for coming out tonight. We hope you enjoyed it, and we will play you this evening. Ready, our final piece of work.
Thank you.